It's no secret that there are some really valuable things in kitchens, so today I am gonna be showing you guys some really valuable kitchen stuff that you can keep an eye out for. Today we're gonna be going to the flea market as well as some estate sales, and we're gonna see what kind of amazing kitchen stuff that we can actually find. One of the very first things that I found was this vintage Simplex tea kettle. You guys, this company is incredibly expensive and these tea kettles are very collectible. People love these things. This company is actually really great because they started in the 1800s, but they didn't start making tea kettles until 1903. And over the last 100 years that they've been making them, they haven't really changed the way that these have been made. These are all still completely handmade and it's a very classic design. And these are incredibly high quality. The outside is either going to be a shiny copper finish or they have these like chrome shiny finishes that are also really cool. This is in really, really good condition. You guys, if you can find them in good condition like this, they'll go for well over $100 and they only wanted $5 for this. And these are one of those things that like you can have and they last forever because of the quality. They completely line the inside with tin so that they're not gonna rust and they're not gonna corrode over time, which is also really great. Now, the next thing that I found, I did not get as good of a price on, but it was still an amazing deal. I paid $80 for this. This is a Le Creuset oval Dutch oven. And the crazy thing about this is it's brand new. This still has the original stickers on it. And it still has the original book that it came with on the inside. They only wanted $80 for this, which I know seems like a lot, but to be honest with you guys, this still has the original price tag on it. That says $344 for a pot. $344 for a pot, you guys. This thing is pretty much brand new. It just doesn't have the box. So $80 is a really good deal for something like this. But if you're not familiar with Le Creuset, they are a French company that is incredibly popular, but their signature look are these different vibrant and bright colors that they put on all of their cookware. And they make tea kettles, they make skillets and pots and pans. They have stuff that's made out of stainless steel. And then they also do stoneware items as well. But their most valuable stuff is going to be this cast iron enamel, which is like what I found here. And if you can find a piece like this in really good condition and something that's actually brand new at a pretty good price, you can usually sell it pretty quickly. But the next thing that I find that I'm going to show you guys is another company that's really well known for their vibrant and crazy colors. This is from a company called Homer Laughlin. It's a line that I'm sure most of you are familiar with called Fiesta. Homer Laughlin is a company that started in the 1800s, but Fiesta ware wasn't actually created until the 1930s. And then it was one of those weird lines that really drove a lot of their business, and then it had these crazy peaks of success over the years, once in the 1930s, again in the 50s, and then again in the early 2000s. It's something that people still pay a lot of money for because it's really good quality and the colors are really cool. And so I found two boxes of this Fiesta ware. Anytime you can find Fiesta ware in the original packaging like this, it's usually a really good deal. Now, unfortunately, this particular color is not one of their most valuable, but the fact that it has the original packaging is really amazing. But they don't actually look used. Like, everything still has the original stickers on them. They only wanted $10 for both boxes. If you can find a really unique color, maybe something that's retired in the original packaging like this, they'll go for well over $100. People really, really like the old Fiesta ware, and it's also really good quality. It's very thick, it's very durable, it's difficult to chip or crack. So even if you have kids, it's a great option. They have like really great reds and blues and yellows and oranges, and a lot of people will actually buy a whole bunch of different colors and just have a huge variety of color dinnerware. There is a lot of really valuable dinnerware that you guys can look for, but one of the really cool ones that I find unique and also very rare is vintage restaurant ware. And one of the companies that makes some really valuable restaurant ware is a company called Wallace China. Wallace China is no longer around. In fact, they were only around until the 1960s, but in the 1930s and 40s, they had specialized in creating some really amazing restaurant ware. So this is stuff that was used in different restaurants at the time. And this was a line called Desert Ware, and this is a pattern that they made called Festival. Not Fiesta, Festival. It's actually really difficult to find complete sets of this stuff. You're usually gonna find like one plate or one bowl or one cup, and even if you do only find one cup, it'll go for quite a bit of money. This guy's only asking $5 for this entire set. It's very easy to spot because you just flip it over and you can kind of see it's got the maker's marks on the bottom, and it even tells you the pattern that's there. This festival pattern has like a poppy design, and it's got a really cool look to it. But again, these are really, really good quality because they were made for restaurants. So they're difficult to break, they're difficult to chip. I'm sure if I slammed it on the ground, it would definitely shatter. This next vintage kitchen item totally caught my attention because this thing is from the 1950s and it is still in the original packaging. This is what's called the lightning icebreaker, and basically it would have been used to crush ice. Back in the day, they did not have a crushed ice option on your refrigerator where you could just walk over and get a bucket full of crushed ice right out of your refrigerator. You had to crush it all by hand, and this was a really convenient way to do that. It was basically a glass cup on the bottom that had this pole with these giant teeth that you would use to manually crush your ice, and you could use this to mix drinks and have like a slushy type drink. And you know, honestly, they're not incredibly valuable. I think this will probably sell for $30 to $50, and they wanted 10, so I paid a little bit more than I would have liked to have. But you guys, this packaging is just like, I'm living for it. Look at this. This lady is like decked out in her 1950s attire, like creating her 1950s cocktail. It's called the Icebreaker, and then it tells you all of the things you can do. It actually has a measuring cup inside. Let's take a look at it, shall we? That's my 1950s voice. We're gonna take a look at this icebreaker. Those look dangerous. These look like they could do some serious damage. But I love that whoever had this kept it in the original packaging. I think that that's kind of incredible. You guys, somebody used this like daily. This thing is destroyed, like scratched. And so then you put your ice in it, crush it, do all kinds of weird stuff with it, and you could make yourself like a slushy. I think it's a cool idea. I like it. It's not very often I buy something just because it has cool packaging, but I do like this packaging quite a bit. It's just very like 1950s kitchen, which is cool. I like it. Now this next thing that I find is actually really cool. This is from a studio pottery artist named Molly Hatch, and she does a lot of really incredible kitchen items. So she does like a lot of plates. She even has a line of glass tumblers, but some of the stuff that her studio has made that is no longer being made, that's been retired or it's been discontinued, some of this stuff can go for a ton of money. So this is definitely a name that you want to keep an eye out for. Her lines are sold through a lot of major retailers, including Anthropologie. She's got a pretty big following. People that really, really want her stuff. It's kind of hard to miss. Like, I feel like if any of you guys would have seen this, you would have picked it up and at least turned it over, and you would have seen the name on the back. All of her pieces are gonna be signed with the stamp on the back, but everything is handmade. And they only wanted $7 for this, so I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna get this and I'm gonna give it a try. You guys, so I feel like we've covered a lot of different things. We've covered some of our cookware. We've also covered ways to make really cool drinks to crush the ice or to make tea, but we haven't covered any knives yet. So this is perfect. I found this set of knives and they only wanted $5 for them, but this is from a company called Ligule, and it's a French cutlery company, and they actually do flatware, they do different knives, but these things are incredibly high quality, and you can find some really amazing, unique designs that this company creates, and they'll make these handles out of bone or horn or wood, and a lot of them are all handcrafted. This is the line here. You guys, they're not even open yet. And then look, they're pretty cool, and they've got like little flies on the edge there. I think the handles are made out of wood. But it looks like these have a weird design where they would fold, and this just looks like a steak knife set. So that's definitely a brand that you guys should keep an eye out for. And I'm totally into the little flies. I feel like everybody should have a little fly stuck to their knife. Right? And now you guys, I'm gonna take you to an estate sale that actually ended up having some really, really cool kitchen stuff. So it fits right in with this video. They had a basket full of this flatware. And immediately when you look at this flatware, you already know it's something weird and something different because it doesn't look like your basic everyday flatware. And this isn't vintage, but this is from a company called Gourmet Settings. And Gourmet Settings actually has a lot of really amazing and really unique flatware designs. And right when you pick it up, you can automatically tell that it's really high quality. It's really heavy. But this is from a line that they created called Treble Clef. Then the ends of them just kind of like curve in this little spiral design. Now, you're you're gonna look, and there's a maker's mark on the very end. It's really small, but it just says GS for gourmet settings. And they actually create a lot of really unique flatware designs. So this is definitely a company that you could look out for. Now, a set like this, they're asking $30 for it. I'm thinking that I can probably get $150 to $200 for this set. It's definitely a really cool, really unique design. I feel like that's a good way to impress your friends at a dinner party. And then the next thing that they had at this estate sale was this entire set of pottery. This is actually from a studio in Ireland called Nicholas Moss. And Nicholas Moss is the guy that started it, and he sort of created it, but it's now this much bigger studio with many employees, and they create these really amazing plates and teapots, and every single piece is gonna be hand-painted, hand-signed, so you're gonna be able to spot them fairly easily because on the bottom, each piece is gonna have the maker's mark. But here's one of the pieces from the set. Every single thing has these designs on it. These are all hand done. So like each flower is done by hand individually. They've got like plates and they have cups and they have like nesting bowls, and certain patterns are gonna be more valuable than others, but they wanted $50 for this entire set. So I ended up just getting all of that because some of these things can be really, really valuable. They also had a bunch of these nesting bowls, which I think are really cool. Each one has that same pattern on it, but it was a good set for that price, and I feel like I'll be able to do pretty well on it. So I hope this was helpful for you guys. These are all really great items that you can keep an eye out for, and these are things that maybe you might want for your own kitchen. These are all really good quality, and a lot of these have some amazing stories behind them. Kitchen stuff for me is really weird because I don't even know like what I have in my kitchen. One of my all-time favorite things to do is when I have people over for dinner. Like, I don't know how to cook, so I do this thing where I invite people over for pizza night. But I give everybody their own personal size dough slice, and then you have to go and like get your own toppings and put it on, and everybody gets their own pizza, and you can make your own style pizza, and it's like a fun idea. But people don't know I do that because I don't know how to cook. I do not want to take responsibility for anything that you eat in my house because I don't understand. Like, I feel like everybody sort of have their little secret shortcuts that they do, right? Like, secret shortcuts, like, oh, maybe they use something canned and then they pass it off as being homemade, or maybe they just go and like pick something up at a restaurant and serve it as something that they actually made, right? Like, I don't think that's weird, but I would be super curious to know if you guys have any like kitchen shortcuts and things that you do that you would never tell anybody else, but it's okay, you can tell them here. I hope you guys have some really good comments that actually make me feel better about my kitchen secret. Now, nobody's gonna wanna come to my pizza nights anymore because now they know why I'm doing it. Come to my house for a personal pan pizza night where you make your own food, and if your dinner sucks, that's on you. If you haven't hit that subscribe button yet, make sure you do it now so you don't miss future episodes. And as always, thank you guys for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.